Well, EG Solutions specializes in back office optimization software and claims to have pioneered the concept. The company listed on AIM in 2005 is just part of that company's story. There's been many chapters, and to tell us all about it, I'm joined by the founder and chief executive, Elizabeth Gooch. Now, Elizabeth, what is back office optimization software and why do companies need it?
Oh, hi there. Okay, so back office optimization is about optimizing the resources that are employed in back offices in mostly big companies, big service sector companies. And essentially in the back office, there's lots of complex processing work that goes on with many inputs of work, long cycle processes, quite chaotic, you know, and for a person that works in those departments, it's quite difficult to work out what it is that I should do next and what is the most important thing and so on and so forth. In the call centre, that problem was resolved in around 1985 with the introduction of workforce management software. And what that essentially does is capture all of the calls that come into the call centre into a product called the ACD, Automatic Call Distributor, capture all the calls and distribute them out to the agents. And it's sorted them into the order that needs to be for them, that they need to do it to meet service standard. In the back office, it's much more complicated to do that because, as I say, there are many sources of work. So essentially, we're the ACD for the back office. Regardless of the source of work, we capture it, we sort it into priority order, we send it to the people who are available with the right skills to actually process that piece of work. And it's really important to have it for a number of reasons. One is increasing compliance and the need and drive for transparency over every piece of work that's done for customers, and we need to evidence it for regulation. The second reason is about customer service, and it's probably the most important reason, but regulation sort of takes over somewhat. And we need to make sure that we're doing the right things in the right order in order to meet customer expectations. And last but by no means least, we need to optimise the resources that we're paying for, make the most use of their time. Through the recession, very important to have the right number of people for the work that we had, which might have meant downsizing, but essentially it improves productivity as well, and so it means organisations can be more cost effective.
Now, you did pioneer this very early on, you know, founded the company in 1988, but since then the nature of the beast, other competitors have come into the market. So what makes your solution still stand out above and beyond the crowd?
Okay. Well, perhaps if I could just perhaps correct one part, if that's okay. Yes, we pioneered the space, but actually started as a management consultancy, and I worked in industry, so my father kept saying, you need to get a proper job, so I went to work in banking. Bit interesting, a bit controversial now anyway. So in banking, I observed all of this sort of chaos in the back office process and introduced production line thinking in order to streamline the processes, improve service, reduce cost. Developed some software, spreadsheets actually, into provide the process control information, and gave it away free. And after working in two or three banks, I set up my own consultancy in order to provide this to customers and sort of build a business for myself. Through that, the software became really important. So we moved from spreadsheets, developed a software package, and moved away from giving it away free to selling it because there was actually demand for it. So the software business, EG Solutions, was actually formed in 2001, and we floated on AIM in 2005. So what that's given us is 25 plus years of domain expertise of solving what's become a very common problem to back offices throughout the world. And our product has inbuilt all of that domain expertise so that out of the box, our product is the most complete solution that any back office could probably need, possibly needs, in order to be able to reduce cost, improve service, evidence compliance. So essentially, we have the leading product by virtue of all of that expertise and experience that we've developed over the last 25 years.
So which clients are being attracted to that expertise?
We built it as a horizontal play, so it can go into any sector. But I mentioned that I worked in financial services when I got my first proper job, as my father called it. And so predominantly our customer base is large financial services businesses, originally based in the UK. So a lot of our client base is UK financial services. But now we distribute our product globally through Aspect Software. And so we have much bigger global customers as well. We're in outsourcers a lot. Obviously, managing service and evidencing what they're doing for their host companies is important. Also in utilities. So we're starting to spread into lots of other sectors as well, but predominantly we're appealing to financial services at this moment in time.
Did you have to spread yourself a bit more? Because 2013 was a tough year for you, but you're now on an even keel. Is it because of that diversification?
No, in fact, I think part of the problem of being a small business is there are so many market opportunities, and certainly for this product, the market is now emerging. So as I say, we built it as a horizontal play. We could go anywhere. There's a lot of theory around really need to concentrate your marketing messages on a single sector and get word of mouth referrals and so on. So that was essentially why we concentrated on financial services. And going into other sectors has largely happened through those referrals as well. But 2013 really wasn't really anything to do with the market. The market is now emerging for our solution. There's calculated a 3.4 billion market for the product, which is great news. But 2013 was really about the culmination of a couple of years of investment in a change in strategy. And that change in strategy was about global distribution, so getting the Aspect relationship, investing in teaching their salespeople throughout the world to sell our product, about us investing in a much longer sales cycle with some global customers. So we knew it was going to have a sort of a depressing effect on our turnover and our results for a couple of years. It was somewhat compounded by some management infighting, which is pretty well publicised and probably don't need to go over anymore. The results are what the results are. But the latent demand that's there in the market for our product, with real focus this year, we've managed to turn it around.
You've mentioned results there, your half-year results, well-received, company returning to profit, like you said, boasting a forward order book worth about £13 million. Yeah. Yet the company is valued at less than that. How are we going to get a revaluation?
I think that revaluation will come. I'm a big believer in you have to earn your valuation rather than get it through froth and hype. Obviously, we've been on the market for a long time, came to market too early. We've done all of our learning and product development and market development being a listed business. Innovation is a bumpy road. It's not predictable. Yes, we've started to grow and we're starting to deliver the results that we believe were there, and now people are starting to see possibly they might be. But one fine day does not a summer make, and it'll take two or three reporting periods before people go, yeah, it is actually turned around. So, yes, I'd love a bigger valuation, but I'm satisfied that the market is starting to recognise that there's a possibility that EG is actually going to be the global player that we want it to be.
You've mentioned one fine day, so I'm thinking about the weather. I'm thinking about the cloud.
Yeah.
Are you in the cloud?
Oh, absolutely, yeah. So we have a managed cloud service, we call it. Obviously, ours is enterprise software, and enterprises are not very keen on SaaS solutions particularly. There's lots of information security processes that we need to comply with, and the idea of moving their customer data into the cloud is still, for financial services, a bit risky. But what we offer is the ability for what we call private cloud, but also a hybrid model, and hybrid is for enterprise software is definitely the way to go. So essentially, what does hybrid mean? It means you can have some on-premise if you absolutely insist on having that, so you've got protection of the data. You can have other parts in the cloud, which means you are reducing the total cost of ownership of the product. Or you can put it all in the cloud. So our utility customers are much happier to have it in the cloud, perhaps retaining a small part on site. But we see that growing very strongly, and that's what's built that order book for us. I think it's something like 56% of our pipeline is all for cloud solutions. So, it's all great news. It's building visibility for the future. It's building long-term valuation, which from an investment point of view, it starts to reduce the bumps in the road that I talked about earlier.
You have stolen my thunder, because my final question was going to be, why is the word hybrid sexy? But you've just answered it.
I don't know. I think ask Honda, actually, with that damn advert that they do.
Elizabeth, we don't have time to talk about Honda, unfortunately, but Elizabeth Gooch, founder and chief executive of EG Solutions, thank you very much indeed for joining us.
Thank you. Thank you so much.